Hey everyone, Ray Sawvell, raysawvell.com. In today's video, we are going to be going through dynamic search ads, or DSAs, how to set up those types of campaigns, how to optimize them, and why they are important, and how you can maximize them in the shortest amount of time possible. If that's what you're looking for, stick around. Dynamic search ads allow you to take your content on your website and allowing Google to go out, crawl that website, match search terms that are relevant to your business, and then you can go out and mine different keyword types. It's an extremely effective way to propagate keyword lists and then expand on your current efforts, learn something new, or just test. And if you pair this with smart bidding algorithms, so like TROAS or TCPA, they really work well together. So you're kind of taking Google's smart bidding options along with their keyword targeting DSAs, and they work together just beautifully. If you haven't done this before, check out my video. There'll be a link somewhere on the screen for bidding methods, when to use them. But in my experience, using DSAs and using smart bidding just work so well together. Now, creating a DSA campaign is pretty straightforward. Now, the process I'm going to be showing you is through the Google Ads interface. You can do the exact same thing on Bing, or if you have both platforms, Google and Bing, everything you do on Google, of course, you can copy it over to Bing, so you can import those settings, no big deal. But if you're in the Google Ads interface, you just want to go to New Campaign, and you're going to end up on this screen here. Now, if you've made a campaign before, you definitely can go through this wizard where you select, hey, I want to get sales or traffic or what have you. We're going to get to the same end point here. I'm going to click create a campaign without goals and guidance. And I'm going to be making a search campaign because dynamic search ads are search campaigns. I'm going to be doing website visits. I'm going to be putting in my website, raysawvell.com. Make sure to check it out. It's such a great website. And then I'm going to name this campaign 01 DSA, just because I like to have naming conventions when I build out campaigns so I can easily find them, categorize them, and optimize in an extremely efficient way. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to call them dynamic search ads so we understand what we're looking at while we are working in this campaign. And then we can click set new. Now, all of these settings are going to be dependent on exactly what you're doing. Your budget, obviously, what you're gonna be bidding towards, all of your targeting. So I'm gonna fly through this. I will have a link somewhere on the screen, probably in the upper right-hand corner, where you can look at bidding. And the reason why this works so well is because if you do smart bidding and combined with DSA, it's like steroids for your campaigns. They work so well together in my experience, so I highly recommend it. But we're gonna leave all these settings default for the purpose of this video. And then campaign settings, again, we're going to leave all of these default, except when you get down to more settings at the bottom down here, this is the most important part. You're going to want to go to dynamic search ads settings, and you're going to enter your domain here. So by you going to this section right here, you're essentially telling Google, hey, I want to make some dynamic search ads campaigns. Great. And here's the website to use. You do have the option to say, hey, look at my entire website that's indexed, looked at specific pages, or you can provide Google with an Excel file or a Sheets file to say, only use these pages. Again, for the purposes of this video, I'm going to select this top option, and you'll be able to get the result that you're looking for anyways, and I'll show you in a few moments. So once you have this campaign setting section finalized, you can then click Next after doing the DSA setting section. Now, what's going to happen is you are not going to have specific keywords to target, obviously. You're only going to have web pages to target. So when building out your campaigns, you're going to say, Google, look at my homepage, look at my category level pages if you're an e-commerce business. If you're a service level business, you can vary it, you can get down to the service level. You can really tell Google exactly what to focus on. So I'm going to start with one section here and say use rules. And the rule that I'm going to say is I typically like to do my homepage for its own ad group, because I'm going to have one ad group saying, just look at my homepage. And then I'm going to have different ad groups saying, look at my category level pages, look at whatever page. So think of your ad groups sort of like your themes that you're going to want to be targeting. So typically it may look something like, here's my homepage ad group, here's my service level ad group. So just think of it that way, because that's the best way to accomplish this in my experience. And you can also do one for all web pages if you want to catch all as well. So you can just say, Google, hit everything. But again, for purposes of this video, I'm going to use exact URLs and I'm going to hit just this page. Now for ad copy, we're not going to do anything here. One of the major callouts with this, though, is with DSAs, it's going to dynamically generate that headline based on the search term. So my website, raysawvell.com, if somebody searches for digital marketing Milwaukee Ray Sawvell or something, and then an ad were to show up in that placement and I were buying that and I had a dynamic search campaign live, in that scenario, the headline would likely be digital marketing expert hyphen Ray Sawvell or something along those lines. Google will show you when you're optimizing the campaigns exactly what those headlines look like. So you do have a little bit of options to optimize around. But the biggest area that you want to be testing here is your description. So I might put in something like, Ray is awesome. Work with Ray today or something. And I'm botching the spelling right here, guys. I'm just choking under the pressure. So I apologize. Google Ads is fun. So anyways, you guys get the ideas of ad copy. This has nothing to do with ads. Right now, we're more so talking about this campaign setup. And then ad extensions. We'll have a different video somewhere down the line regarding the best way to set up ad extensions. But for purposes of this video, we are going to skip this section. And then we just need to... Oh, and I forgot to click the most important step, guys. When you get here, you need to click add. When you click add, it adds it over to this right-hand section over here, and this is telling you exactly what that ad group is hitting. Very important step that I always forget when creating in the interface, so don't be like me. Be better than me. And then I'm going to click next, and I'm going to finalize this. So now, this campaign is now published, and my ads are going to be serving out there right now with Ray Sawvell. I'm going to pause this right now for the purposes of this video because I don't want ad serving quite yet. And if you guys remember from a targeting standpoint, we are hitting the homepage. So I'm going to call this ad group homepage. Now, let's say I wanted to hit people that were viewing specific pages on my website. So I have a blog section on my website where I talk about different tools, and I want to hit everything that has YouTube in my URL bar up here. I can then make a new ad group in this campaign for my DSA. I'm going to call this YouTube pages. And then I can say, it needs to be dynamic, by the way. You need to select dynamic from this dropdown. And then I'm going to create rules and saying URL contains YouTube. Now this is all like Boolean logic where you can just put in like, I believe it's just contains. I don't think you can do regex. So it's very much just contains. And when you exclude web pages later, you can do negative keywords. So I believe it's actually just straight contains or does not contain. You can also do like and you can do all that fun stuff. But for purposes of this video, I'm going to say it contains YouTube. And now the great part about this, guys, is you can have unique ad copy just for YouTube or for whatever service or category you're doing. So if you're like a plumbing service or an HVAC service or a lawyer, whatever, you can get down to the ad group level by web pages and make sure that that ad copy speaks specifically to that service or product. And the reason why that works so well is because your click-through rates are going to be so much higher, allowing you to get more clicks for the same budget, all that kind of fun stuff. And in my experience, quality score is not impacted too much with DSA campaigns. And that's like a whole other conversation when it comes to DSAs and smart bidding. But just like another way to kind of flex like your DSA muscles a little bit. So I'm going to cancel this ad group because... That's kind of the main purpose of that campaign right there. But yeah, that's how you build DSA campaigns. They're pretty straightforward, and they work really well. And once you do that, you can say, here are my homepage ads, here are my YouTube ads, product category, obviously, and you can get very specific with them. The last thing I'm going to want to talk about here is your negatives. So the one thing that works different with these types of campaigns when you're negative things out is obviously you can do like your negative keywords and all that fun stuff. So you can apply shared negative lists and all that kind of stuff. So definitely continue with that. But the one thing that is different that I'm finally getting towards here is the dynamic ad targets. So you can see that I have one ad group here in dynamic ad targets that's hitting these pages, one that's hitting these pages. You can also do negative dynamic targets. So let's say I have an About Us page on my website or some content that I never want ads to serve for. In my experience, it's things like about pages, sometimes blogs because the intent is so much higher and it may not be extremely relevant to your business depending on what it is. You can go to create negative dynamic ad targets, and the same thing is going to show up where you can create it for the campaign or the ad group level. And you can say, hey, if I have anything that says blog in my ad copy, I'm sorry, on my website, I don't want to serve ads for it. So now you're telling Google, go hit everything that has YouTube, go hit everything that has my homepage, raysalvo.com. But if you see anything with the blog, I don't want you to bid on that at all, and I don't want you to send any traffic to those pages. So again, when doing optimizations, you want to make sure you're doing negative keywords, but you also want to be doing negative dynamic ad targets and also looking at your search terms, because obviously I don't have anything right here, but you can very much get down to and say, here is the search term that triggered this landing page. So when doing maintenance on these types of campaigns, it's going to look a little bit different, where it shows you the search term and it shows you the landing page where it sent traffic to, which is a little bit different, which you don't typically see in standard campaigns. And that's it, folks. That's the very basic of a dynamic search campaigns. If you have any questions, if you need more clarification, make sure to drop a comment down below. Also, if you found this content useful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up and potentially a subscribe. This channel has been growing at a pretty steady pace over the past month or two, and I would appreciate that continued support and to continue to have YouTube recommend this content to other people just like you. So if you found this content helpful, please make sure to like and subscribe. I would very much appreciate it. Until next time, thank you very much. Appreciate it. See ya.